What you want. Well, bowling fans, we're back. Week two of the Van McNeil's Road to the Summer Swing blog. We'll get to Van later on. He's been working hard all week. I know you were coaching him again with his physical game, Dwight. And we want to talk about really first and foremost what we ended up with last week talking about to Van and you, which is the one ball arsenal. He's got that Brunswick aura right now. Kind of tough to bowl a PBA Tour stop with just one bowling ball, especially three different conditions.
Yeah, you're looking at a golfer that uses just a 7-iron to play a round of golf. Obviously, they did it in Tin Cup, but that's a movie. That's not reality. And reality is that you obviously have to have a nice array of equipment, and you got to make sure that all the balls don't react the same, so we can pick and choose what ball has to be used on that condition.
Well, thanks to the people at Brunswick, they heard about Van's plight on the Spare Time Bowling Show. Kevin DeBron from Brunswick called in a couple of Sundays ago and offered a couple of free balls for Van to try out. And we don't know what the conditions are going to be for the summer series yet. That's the problem. I mean, we know there's going to be a bear pattern, a badger pattern, and a wolf pattern. But the PBA isn't releasing those until May 1st. So really, even if you get the bowling balls now, you're kind of shy about drilling them up.
Yeah, exactly. You don't want to go into this blindly. Obviously, with the current animal patterns that are out there, these pros know exactly, again, what ball is going to work best, what layout's going to work best. So kind of going into this blindly, that's no good either. So we would like to get as much education on the ratios and on the volumes and how the pros will play them before we actually lay them out for Van.
So once we get those around May 1st, the PBA said they're going to be coming out. We'll figure out exactly how the bowling balls are going to drill. But let's just go with some generics here so people kind of get an idea, because people are always curious too. There's going to be people that try bowling sport leagues in the summer or PBA experience leagues. So here's maybe what you should be looking at. Let's say one of the patterns ends up being like a really short, like 33, 34, 35 feet. What out of the Brunswick lineup here would you recommend for somebody to drill up?
Yeah, that's easy, Phil. We're obviously going to be looking at like a ringer, or we're going to look at a mean streak. The other big thing is we got to find out how the person releases the ball, because if the guy like Van stays more behind the ball, certain drillings are going to work well for that type of release. So Van, with that high track that he has and that low tilt, he's going to like the pins way up above the fingers, probably a lot of distance away from his axis point, like 5, 5.5 inches. So as an example, opposite to me would be like a spinner. That drilling will not work for me, even though the blueprint or the makeup of the ball is designed for dry lanes. So you got to know the drilling too, but those are two great choices for drier lanes.
And moving up, I mean, there's going to be, you know, they're going to stick a medium pattern in there. They always do when they do these rotations of patterns. So figure it's going to be something 38, 40, 41 feet.
Right, exactly. Like a Viper. Mm-hmm.
So what, moving up the line here, I would assume we're kind of in an order a little bit here. Yeah. What will we see for Van for a medium-type pattern?
Well, you're going to be looking at like a Brawler or a 3X Nexus, and those are your big hooking polished reactives with the big weight blocks in the ball. They tend to read the mid lane a little bit better than obviously like a mean streak or a ringer. So obviously Jason Sterner had a lot of success in the Detroit team swing with the Brawler. Sean Rash used the Brawler on the Detroit swing. So those balls obviously matched up real well on that medium type of pattern. And that will also be the case for Van.
And then, of course, thinking we're going to see a line pattern, we could even maybe see it at AMF Waukesha, because it's old wood. And they're going to have to do something to really keep the front part of the lane flooded so they don't get a lot of early reaction on wood. We can maybe even see like a 50-foot old-fashioned tournament of champions pattern out there. So with Van's forward roll, he's probably going to go way high-end up on the performance ladder to get something going for a 50-foot pattern.
Absolutely. Then that's why they have their Aura series. The Paranormal Aura would obviously be the great oil ball for him, especially for the longer patterns, as it's going to obviously want to read the lane a little bit sooner. Bigger weight block, sanded at 2,000, and then obviously giving him a little bit more of a higher flare drilling to help create a little bit more overall hook. You're right. The big thing that we got to worry at AMF Waukesha, though, is how quick they're going to break down with that old neglected wood.
So lots of ball choices out there, and like we said, we don't know how exactly they can get drilled up yet, because we want to make sure that the bowling balls are tuned to the patterns and tuned to Van's release in game.
Exactly. That's the term is matching up.
So lots of that to look forward to during the next couple of blogs. We're going to get it over to Van McNeil in a minute. He's on the lanes practicing, working hard, working on everything that Dwight's told him here over the last couple of weeks, and we'll get caught up with Van in just a moment. We're going to take a short break, and make sure you stay tuned.
Dwight Albrecht and Phil Brilo both use MotionView bowling coach software to analyze their players. Whether you're a coach or a bowler looking to improve, purchase your copy of MotionView at bowlingcoachsystems.com.
Join Steve Sparky Pfeiffer, Van the Man McNeil, Dwight Five-Time Albrecht, and other guests as they talk about the PBA Tour and local bowling on the Spare Time Bowling Show, Sunday mornings at 9 a.m. on Sports Radio 1250 WSSP.
The PBA is back in Milwaukee with the Geico Summer Swing. Four tournaments beginning with the PBA Badger Open and ending with the Geico Summer Swing TV tapings on June 1st and June 2nd. Watch the best bowlers in the world or bowl with them in one of the three Geico Summer Swing Pro-Am events. You can receive information on the Pro-Ams or purchase your tickets for the TV tapings at PBA.com.
Well, we're back. Van the Man McNeil, Road to the Summer Swing. We talked to Dwight already. We got some ideas about the equipment we're going to use for you. We don't know the PBA parents quite yet. We'll learn those around May 1st, and then we'll Dwight says he'll do a good job drilling those out for you. But we decided this week, not going to work on the physical game too much with you on TV, but we got you some different experiences out there. Dwight had a rocky idea moment, like get you out fighting, that kind of thing. So we took you down to the Holler House in Milwaukee, get you back to like the old-time basics of bowling, and I think you had a pretty good time down there.
I had an amazing time down there. For never being at the Holler House ever, what an amazing place. And if you're a bowler and you love bowling, you got to go down there. And what is it, the oldest certified lanes in the world?
At least in the U.S. Yeah. I mean, 105 years old they're celebrating this year, and it's still the original wood once you get on the approach and past the foul lines.
Right, and the pin setters there, the manual pin setters and the crew, that's just an amazing place, the Holler House.
If you've never been there, you should. It's like one of the places that should be on your bucket list if you're a bowler.
Absolutely. So we started at the Holler House. Of course, met up with Coach this week, and you know, we're still working on that physical game and getting that down. We talked about equipment, and then went to Indiana and bowled in a tournament down there. Of course, as PVA's Jason Sterner said, just get involved in tournaments with better bowlers, and it'll make you a better bowler. I'm a little tired, not gonna lie. Physically, I'm out of it, but we're still building here.
But you learned a lot. I mean, it was a pattern that nobody really sees. They kind of designed their own patterns down at Stardust in Dyer, Indiana, for these weekly Friday night King of the Hill tournaments. Mm-hmm. And yeah, pretty good showing first time down there. 70 plus bowlers, and you finished in the top 16, so not too shabby. And there's some big names like Brian Valente, who's out on the PBA Tour, and some regional guys like Kevin Coleman,
yeah,
as well.
Our friend Kevin Coleman was down there, and he sends his regards. But, you know, he was down there offering his help and lining me up and saying, hey, you're doing this, you're doing that, and adjusting. So, like I said before, the whole bowling community is just rallying around this. I love it.
Which is great. But there's one more thing we got to help rally around on you for, and that's I heard spare shooting was a rumor, that the spare shooting still a little bit work needs to be done on it.
So I go to this thing in Indiana and qualify. I advance to match play, and in the second round of match play, three opens, which in the end cost me the game by 9 pins. Had I made those three spares, and just like the pros say, make your spares, I would have advanced to the finals.
Yeah, you make one of them on a single pin, you get 11 more, and there you go. You're on your way to the next round.
So still lots more work to do. I'm excited for where I am, but you know, where am I going to be next? I don't know. I'm working my butt off. I'm hungry. I am hungry, Phil.
And I'm seeing you checking maps, what tournaments are going around. I know you're looking at going to Madison. You're even looking at maybe even going to St. Louis. I think we talked you out of that one, though. Yeah. That's long for a one-day trip.
Yeah, it is. You know, the pros are doing a PBA practice session down there, and it would be nice, but, you know, with time and money and gas and travel, yeah, we could lay that stuff out here. So I'm still practicing. I'll get it in there.
Yeah. And as that arsenal gets bigger, we'll get you that spare ball next, that polyester spare ball, so you work on that spare game.
Absolutely. That was the key. I was so frustrated. Had I made those spares, I maybe would have made it to the finals.
And they could have called you a King of the Hill champion, but it'll have to wait till I'm sure you'll be down there at Stardust 3 again very soon.
Yeah. Well, as soon as we get to Summer Swing here, I'm just going to bowl as many tournaments as I can just to get that experience.
Keep getting the experience out there, Van. Thanks once again.
Absolutely.
Another week for Van's Road to the Summer Swing blog is in the books. We'll come back next time. Check out as we get closer. Maybe we'll get some more information on what's going on with the PBA shots. Maybe we'll get some more stuff, some more pros to help you out. You never know what might happen. So be sure to stop back next time. For my friend Van McNeil, for Dwight Albrecht, Spare Time Pro Shop in New Berlin, Wisconsin, at New Berlin Bowl, I'm Phil Brilo, and parents take the kids bowling. They'll have fun for life. We'll see you on the next blog. What you want.
Come on.